Well, hello, my tiny terrors. This is Jeff from CompuTerrors, and today I'll be going over the best password manager, which I believe is KeePass. It's spelled KeePass. Now, this is just going to cover the very basics, and this is the best offline password manager, meaning everything is stored on your computer itself, not online. For later on, we'll do other videos for other online password managers. What you do to get it is you go to keypass.info, which I know that address is weird, but the awesome thing about KeePass is it's free, it's open source, meaning the code that it's used to create the program is openly available and people work on it all the time, so it's very quick for bugs or things like that to get worked out. KeePass 2.3 is the newest version, so I'll just go to download here, and you can actually click on downloads. Now there's two different versions. There's a classic edition and professional. Without getting into all the details, there's a lot of technical reasons. Just use the professional edition. You get more, and again, it's free. There's an installer, meaning it'll actually install the program on your system itself, or there's a portable version, so you can run this and store your passwords just on a file on a USB drive if you want, so you have options. I use the one that's the actual installer, so that you just click on this, and then it should download automatically. If it doesn't, just click on the direct link and then it'll open. Now, I already downloaded it. I have it installed. So I'm just going to close this. And then I'll run it. So again, this will just be the basics of how to use KeePass. Now, that first window that came up when I ran it, that's because it was searching for an old database I created that's no longer here. So again, we'll just do a very quick version of this. So this is the default window. There's no databases open yet. Now, if you even using a password manager like this, you'll be completely ahead of the game. Most people don't like passwords, so they'll choose something really simple. And in this day and age, I mean, that's just asking for trouble. So you want to have more complex passwords. And the hard part is you can't remember them. That's why you have a password manager like KeePass, because then you don't have to remember them. You just remember the main password to get into this database file that we're going to create, and then all your other passwords will be stored. So you want to be careful of where you save this database. But beyond that, as long as you have a strong password to get in there, you're much more protected. So to create something, you just click on New. And then this is just asking me where I'd want to save it. I'll just save it on my desktop. Now, again, there's going to be a lot of extra options here, but we're just going to go over the basics. So you want to choose a master password. This is the password you'll use to get into this password manager database. So I'll put, this is my super password. This is my super. Okay, now you can see that you type it in once and then twice. It'll show you the quality, meaning how difficult this password is to remember, or not even that, but how good of a password it is. So you want to be closer to the right than not. You definitely want to be in the green, because that's a better password. Now remember, this is the main password that you'll have to remember to get into KeePass. It seems like 20-something characters is a long password, but this is the only password you'd have to remember, so you want to make it a good one, because this is the master password to get into your database of all your other passwords. So you could use a technique called chunking. It takes a bunch of smaller words and numbers that you do remember very easily, and you just add them all together. So you could put a pet name, and then a number, and then maybe a birth date, and then a street address or something like that. And just by doing those things, as long as you remember the order that those things are in, each chunk of the password's easier. But when you add it all together, it's much more difficult for people to remember. Now, technically, you should still use other characters in a password, like dollar signs and hashtags, ampersands, things like that. But these are options to make it easier to remember, because I get it, I'm an IT person, but people hate passwords, so I'm just being more realistic. And so you can actually choose passwords that are more difficult, but still using simple words. The key file, you don't have to worry about that. We're just going to use the password that you type in. For IT departments or people with domain controllers, this is where you'd use a Windows user account, but for the basic use, we don't have to worry about that. So just hit OK. Now, again, none of these options we're going to worry about. This is just a very simple overview, so hit OK. And then this is the sample database. By default, KeePass will put a couple entries in there just to show you how it works, so I would definitely look at these just to see. The cool thing is you can categorize your passwords in all these different folders. These are the defaults that come with KeePass, but you can create your own. So you can right-click and go to Add Group, Edit Group. You can do all sorts of different things. You could export all your passwords in a different file. But again, we're just going to use the defaults. If you click on an entry, this is what the default view looks like. You have the title of the entry, your username. So if this is, say, a Facebook account, you'd have your username, your password, you repeat it, and then the quality. This is a bad password. You'll see why. The URL, so the web address. So this could be facebook.com, say, and then any notes. You might have specific notes about that password or that place. Really, you could do anything. You can set an expiration time for that password. Again, that's more advanced. It's good to do that, but you probably wouldn't want to do that if you want to easily remember it. If you click on the little Show Hide Password, the ellipses button, then it'll actually show you the password that's stored. So this is good if someone's looking over your shoulder. They won't see it until you click on that. Now, you would never, ever want to use the password, but this is just here as a default to show you what to do. So to create an entry, you'd either right-click and go to Add Entry, or you just click the little icon up here with the key. So click that. And now we would you want to type in a title. And you don't have to, but we'll just call it Facebook. And then the username, I'll put, this is just a sample. And then the password. Now, the default password, it'll actually choose one for you. It's that whole long mess, but that's a good password because you can see how good the quality of that password is. And again, you won't have to remember it because it's in here. It's in this database. So I'll actually just keep that. And then if I wanted to write down a URL, which you don't have to, I'd put facebook.com and then notes. This is me. And then you just hit OK. Again, all these other things, they're more advanced. Just for the basics, this is all you need to know. And then hit OK. Now, the biggest thing to remember is this isn't actually saved yet until you hit this little icon or hit Control S, which will save it. So hit the little disk icon, and now that's in your database. So now, if I close this, and then I go back into KeePass, it'll ask for that master file, or that master password, I mean. So I can type in, this is my super password, and then click OK, and now I'm in. So by using that one password, I can come in here and I can have 100 passwords if I wanted to, and everything's in here. And now if I want to, you can right click on an entry and go to copy username, or you can copy the password, and then that way you can paste it in a web browser or anywhere. And the cool thing is if you say copy password, now it copies it into your clipboard. So it's in there. You can hit Control V to paste or go to Edit, Paste in any program in Windows, but it only keeps that information in there for 12 seconds. Now it's gone. So that protects you. That's another layer of protection. So again, we just went over the very basics of the password manager, but this, again, you'll be leaps and bounds ahead of everybody else if just by using a password that's stronger, instead of all these little tiny ones and easy ones that people guess and then they could get into your stuff. And especially when you're dealing with banking and things like that, you want to have something stronger. So anyway, we'll do other videos later on that are more advanced. But this is why I believe that KeePass is the best password manager. It's free, it's open source. And if you have any comments, please leave them below the video. I would definitely appreciate if you subscribe to the Computerrorist channel. And that's it for today. So we'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.